Guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sarah. If you are new here, welcome, welcome. Today I'm going to be showing you guys some of my favorite products I've been loving and using a lot during quarantine, because I know being stuck at home is making a lot of people realize what their true favorite products are, what they truly reach for when it comes to makeup, skincare, you know, stuff like that. And so yeah, I thought I'd show you guys just some things that I personally have found myself using on the daily basis. Just stuff I've been gravitating towards, stuff that I've been loving. So yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the video. So starting out with skincare, for those of you guys who saw some of my previous videos where I talked about skincare, you'd know that I was using Curology. It didn't make my skin like bad by any means, but I think my skin just looked a little bit better before I started it. I tried it for around a month, probably a little bit over a month, and I don't think it worked for me. I don't know if it was like the formula they created or something was off, but I had a lot of texture around my chin, which is normal for me. I switched back to just my regular Cetaphil cleanser just to see if it would, you know, clear things up, and it did.
That last clip reminded me so much of this video of Millie Bobby Brown putting nothing on her face. I promise you guys, I was washing my face. I don't know why I look like this.
This is what my dermatologist recommended to me back in the beginning of high school, I wanna say, like 9th grade, 10th grade. And so I always, always go back to this, just plain old Cetaphil Gentle Skin Cleanser. And my skin is like the best it's looked since the beginning of the year, basically. And then going along with that, just some good old CeraVe. You can't go wrong with CeraVe. It is just the most gentle moisturizer. It's really moisturizing, at least for me. I have dry skin, so I put this on, a lot of it on in the morning and night. And yeah, so these have been my skincare go-tos during this time. Literally back to basics. I just put both of these on. It's simple and it works for me, but I've been loving these. So next up for skincare, this isn't face skincare, but this is just body skincare. So I have been trying out the Glossier Body Hero, the wash, and the Daily Perfecting Cream, and I'm obsessed. I love the smell of this, and I think I like it so much because of the smell. So if you don't like fragrances, this might not be for you. But I think it's just a nostalgic smell for me. It kind of smells like sunscreen and just the beach. I think my mom used to have a lotion that smelled like this when I was a kid, and so it reminds me of her, and I think that's another reason why I like it. But it just makes me feel really luxurious and really nice. I don't know, when I use the body oil cleanser too, it feels so nice because I've just never tried an oil cleanser before, and it just feels like it's nourishing and luxurious, and I feel like it just feels like it's good for my skin, you know what I mean? But yeah, specifically this lotion, I've been really liking. It makes my skin feel really soft and really smooth, and again, I think it's just like a nostalgic smell for me, and so that's why I've been really liking it. But yeah, I've been wearing this almost every single day, and so I had to add this lotion, although I've only had it for a short time, but I've been applying it every single day, so it's definitely one of my favorites. Another thing that I've been trying to wear every single day while, even if I'm inside, even if I'm just going for a quick walk, even if I'm, you know, attempting to garden in my backyard, I have been trying to remember to put on sunscreen, and I've been really liking the Supergoop Glow Screen. I picked this up at a Sephora in California a few months ago when I went on a trip there. You didn't need to know that. I don't know why I gave you that detail. I've been really liking this. I like the way it looks on my skin. I feel like it really makes it look glowy. It makes it look nice and healthy, and I think it's just a nice product for me. It kind of looks like Future Dew, has a similar consistency to Future Dew, but it's Future Dew with an SPF, you know what I mean? It's just SPF 40, and I've been really liking this. I want to pick up another sunscreen from Supergoop. I think I saw they have a spray, so you can kind of spray it over your makeup or just whenever you need to if you're out and about, and I kind of want to get that. And so yeah, I've just been trying to wear this every single day, but I've been loving it so much. The next two things are lip products that I cannot live without. Okay, so the first one is just the Smith's Rosebud Salve. And I think I picked this up on Amazon. They have a 3-pack of like different scents. I almost said flavors, but that's not correct. I think my favorite is just this rose one, but this has been my favorite product for probably like 4 years now for your lips. It's just really moisturizing and I like how it leaves my lips looking really glossy, so it kind of is like a gloss that's good for your lips, I guess. And the next thing is a new product I picked up probably, I want to say, 6 months ago. I have this by my bed at night over there, just on my nightside table, and when I come in my room before I go to bed, you know, I just put some on my lips, and when I wake up, my lips are so soft. I've really been liking this. This is the Laneige, I'm not sure. Lip sleeping mask, and this is, I wanna say, their original scent. It doesn't really say what scent it is, but it's just the pink one, and I really like this. I saw they have one in vanilla, and I really wanna get that, so I think I'm gonna get that next. But yeah, these are two lip products I cannot live without. Now moving on to makeup, I only have 3 makeup products because, as you can imagine, I haven't been doing my makeup much during this time. And so these are just 3 products that I've kind of been picking up for some reason. I guess because they're good and because I like them. The first thing is this M Cosmetics brow cream. Oh my god. So this is in the shade Brunette, and I have been obsessed with this. It just deposits the perfect amount of product. It doesn't get clumpy. My eyebrows stay in place all day, and it's just amazing. I also like how small the wand is as well. I think it's just my new favorite brow product, and it makes my brows look darker and look a little bit more filled in when I didn't fill them in. It makes me feel more put together even when I'm not really wearing much else. They just look thicker and fuller, and they just stay in place. So yeah, I really like this. Another thing I've been loving is Lash Slick, and I think it's because of how natural it makes my lashes look. Wait, that didn't make sense. It doesn't make my lashes look clumpy or like there's too much on them, if that makes sense. I think that's why I actually didn't really like this mascara at first, is because I was like, it just looks like my lashes but better kind of thing, which I should have expected that from Glossier, you know? I usually like a mascara that really lengthens and one that you can tell I'm wearing mascara, but on the day-to-day basis, I've really been liking Lash Slick. I think it looks great on my bottom lashes, great on my top lashes, and it just gives them a nice little wispy, natural definition. And also I like it because it's easy to come off too at the end of the day. It doesn't like leave smudges on my face or anything like that. So yeah, I've been really liking Lash Slick from Glossier. And last but not least, I have a lip product, which I have been putting on like a different color of these almost every day, and it is the Revlon Super Lustrous Lips. I think it's like Shine Lips or Revlon Super Lustrous Lip Shines, something like that. It has a super long name, but they are just this really buttery, kind of like an oil-based lip product, and I really like it just because it's comfortable on the lips. It kind of fades nicely throughout the day, if that makes sense. It's one of those things where I feel like you either love it or hate it, because it doesn't last very long, quite frankly, and it kind of moves around a lot, but I really like products that are kind of oily and moisturizing and glossy, and with wearing those products a lot comes not having them on your lips very long. But I just like it because it adds just a nice little wash of color. I'm wearing the shade Glaring Coral today, but yeah, it's just a nice little drugstore lipstick that's a little shiny and like oily kind of. So if you like those kinds of lip products, I think you'll like it. I did do an IGTV swatching all these shades that I have, and I will go ahead and link that down below for you guys if you wanna see some of the colors, so you can decide if you want to pick it up for yourself, then you can, you know, definitely check that out. But yeah, those were all of my quarantine skincare and makeup favorites. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was really fun for me to do. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to check out all of the links down below. And as always, I hope you guys are staying safe and healthy during this time. I'd love to know what products you've been loving during quarantine. Is there anything that you've had in your shelf or collection for a while that you're revisiting, or is there anything new you're discovering that you really like? Let me know, because I love trying new products and I love hearing from you. I love hearing from you guys about products you've been liking. So yeah, thanks again for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye guys!